In this video, something about the constant current source. And I've made this test circuit with a few white LEDs and a BD139 NPN silicon transistor with a amplification factor of say 100, 120. And at first I want to go to my book. It is in Dutch, by the way. Anyway, I did a few experiments regarding that constant current source. And this is a somewhat more elaborated circuit. And the essential saying of this circuit is that we keep the voltage parallel to a resistor, that's here 82 ohms. We keep the voltage constant with the help of a zener or with the help of a transistor that amplifies that zener effect. And when the voltage here parallel to a resistor in the lead where the current flows is held constant, the other say loads in that circuit also have a constant current. That's the principle, and here you see that principle in a much more bare way. A zener here, a resistor here, a load, and over parallel to that series resistor there is a constant voltage under all circumstances. Could be say 10 volt, 20 or 40 volts. That means that the load also gets that constant current. And on the World Wide Web you see many, many circuits about constant current sources with transistors, with field effect transistors, etc., etc. But this is a kind of bare way to show what happens in such a circuit. Here the explanation. Of course, such a zener is not ideal. It acts on temperature changes. It can get very hot, especially on higher voltages. So we need a kind of amplifier to amplify that zener effect, and we use a transistor for amplifying that zener effect. So the zener is not ideal, it gets hot, the tolerance is quite big on different voltages, it also is temperature dependent, etc. It's very important what is the load. In a certain way important, because it could be a light emitting diode that has a polarity, positive and negative, but when it's an incandescent lamp, and that's my experiment here. Here I made a circuit with a transistor, and you could switch two incandescent lamps in series, but the current stayed the same. But an incandescent lamp, of course, differs from a light emitting diode, and that's here. I have mounted here three light emitting diodes in a row. And that's the good thing of the constant current source. When you mount a lamp or a light emitting diode in a row, they all get the same voltage and current, especially the same current. So this is the circuit that you see here. 1K potentiometer, 82 ohms resistor, a few white LEDs in a row, and here a diode. And I've done that by purpose because this circuit can also be connected to an AC source going up to say 50 volts. That's important. And here the schematic. I've used now three white LEDs, and in the past I used different LEDs. But of course it's important that these LEDs in a certain way have to have the same properties. So here I've used three identical white LEDs, and the circuit will not work properly, for instance, when you combine, say, this LED with such a LED in series here, and even such a LED in series. So, for instance, this one here. You have to search that out, and when you want to be sure, say buy a few identical LEDs. They are very cheap at the moment, etc. So here's the circuit again, and the transistor. The LEDs must be identical. Of course, you can use a different color LEDs when their, say, properties are the same. Green, red, and white. White LEDs often don't match good with green and red LEDs, but anyway, you can try it. And here you can set a current. The final current through the circuit, and I've now hooked up this circuit to an AC source of 30 volts. And we read on the meter 42 volts, okay. And you can set a current through these LEDs with the help of this potentiometer. Of course, it's an experimental circuit. When you make it in a, say, fixed circuit, of course, measure the the resistances when the potentiometer is on the good position that you need for a certain purpose. And here you see what happens when I change the potentiometer somewhat. Of course, you can say, well, this tells us that there's more current. Of course, is this a real current source? Well, it is in a certain way. And let's put out all the lights to see the good effect of this circuit. The LEDs are not damaged, and here we have that 1K potentiometer, and we can change somewhat. The current through the LEDs. So it's an experimental circuit. Put on the lights again. But, well, it, say, in a certain way conforms to the constant current source. We'll now go to the DC source. DC source of 41 volts. And you can see a very, very fierce LED light. This is extremely fierce. On 41 volts. Let's change the 1K potentiometer somewhat. So it's a circuit with which you can surely get, say, a few LEDs into conduction in a good way, preventing that they get too hot, etc., etc. So it's a useful circuit, and that's the reason why I publish it. Perhaps it's not a very, very stable constant current source, but it's a useful circuit that can be used everywhere, especially when you want to, say, connect LEDs, light emitting diodes, in series. And that's what I've done here. Three white LEDs connected in series. Series connection of LEDs always, say, can give a kind of problem, because the properties of the LEDs must be exactly the same, and when they differ somewhat, it doesn't work.